Big snowstorms on the East Coast so far. Another one on its way. Florida being hit with snow. Alabama being hit with snow for the first time in a decade. Europe being hit by snow. Record snowstorms. Essentially, the whole of the Northern Hemisphere experiencing something. I strongly suspect we are, in fact, living in interesting times. The battle cry of those not well-versed in science is that global warming is a farce. But of course, global warming was turned into climate change. And there's good reason for that, because climate change, global warming, doesn't mean that automatically and immediately the Earth is going to just do nothing but steadily warm up. It means that there are going to be very disparate weather patterns, altercations in climate that start out slowly and then quicken. A lot of our best scientists, those armed with not only degrees, but with lab coats. Some of the more goofy ones in a lab coat and sneakers. But I want to show you something that harkens from page 231 of my master's thesis that I wrote about a decade ago. I don't think it's going to help to show you the text. We'll try something else. But above all, please listen. If not for me, do it for the children. The children. Like Eric Cartman. Do it for Eric Cartman. Augie, what do you think about climate change?
It's going to destroy the world!
And of course, she may well be right. But it's not the end of the world. It's just the end of civilization for a while. And let me tell you why. Let me tell you what all of these storms, these very strange snowstorms, all across the Northern Hemisphere, have in common with climate change, and what it may mean in terms of a triggering effect for something more phenomenal, more serious, more deadly, more catastrophic. Here's the greenhouse effect. The sunshine's shortwave radiation, ultraviolet light, comes in through the double-pane glass of a greenhouse, the inner enclosure. It begins to warm the inside and re-radiate as long-wave radiation. The double-pane glass works as an insulator and keeps this heat inside. The heat cannot escape. The double-pane glass acts as the CO2, the counterpart to CO2 in the atmosphere, the thing that traps the heat. Most of the energy of sunlight strikes the equator directly, heating this area, and the heat is dispersed to the northern and southern hemispheres through weather systems well established, which creates our local climates in these various zones. The key signature of a runaway greenhouse effect would be the buildup of heat along this equatorial zone and the heat beginning to move higher up into the troposphere. All of that heat that is generated at the equator has traditionally always been a surface phenomenon. Usually, you know, a mile high, right up here in the tropical, in the subtropical zone around the equatorial area of the Earth. A phenomenon that has been noted in recent years has been the rise of the heat from the equator farther up into the troposphere, into areas that were, you know, usually very cold, very frigid. And when this happens, it leaves a vacuum in this area and in this area. And of course, the vacuum that has been left in the equatorial zone was filled by air sweeping down from the Arctic all across the Northern Hemisphere. That's why Europe and the United States has been experiencing these really terrible snowstorms. So I'm kind of surprised I haven't heard anything much about that. But the fact that air in the upper atmosphere has been warming for a long time, because heat has to go someplace. I mean, the Earth has to find ways, you know, to get rid of heat. That's why we have typhoons, hurricanes, tornadoes. It's the Earth's way of moving heat from the surface of the Earth away from the Earth. So what may be in store for the Northern Hemisphere in the summer? Extraordinarily humid conditions, a lot of water vapor in the lower and the upper atmosphere. And of course, water vapor is the greater greenhouse gas that became the greater greenhouse gas as a result of the buildup of carbon dioxide. And this is the vehicle through which a runaway greenhouse effect begins to happen. So, you know, looking at ice cores from the past, such a thing can happen in a matter of like a year or 2 years. It can actually happen that fast. So, I just thought I'd throw this video out there. I thought it was interesting. Even more interesting that, you know, I haven't really seen much in the science area about this. So, anyway, thanks for watching and for listening.